And so then we decided that it would be fun to actually just make a space for women to be able to drink whiskey unbothered by other people and unmansplained to.
For too long, the image of the typical whiskey drinker has been this.
You don't know how to drink, your whole generation. You drink for the wrong reasons. My generation, we drink because it's what men do.
But that's all changing. We're going inside the world of women who whiskey.
You may not know it, but there's a growing culture of women who enjoy whiskey. In the 1990s, women only made up about 15% of whiskey drinkers, but now that number is up to 37%. Julia is the founder of a club of over 10,000 women around the world who meet up to enjoy whiskey together. She got the idea for Women Who Whiskey when she noticed lots of other whiskey drinkers were women.
And I was ordering old fashions and Manhattans, and then I would see maybe someone else. It was usually a woman. And I would use it as a conversation starter. I'd be like, hey, oh, you're drinking Manhattan too? Like, what's in yours? And we would have the same conversation over and over, which was like, yeah, I love whiskey. I don't understand why people think that's so weird. And it wasn't just people thinking it was weird. It was a lot of like active condescension. Like, are you sure you can handle that drink? That's a strong one. Or are you sure you wouldn't rather have some wine? And then it kind of became this slow burning rage where we were just like, this is insane. And we're just so angry that this continues to be the case.
Julia turned her anger into action and formed a whiskey club for women by women.
So they were just so delighted to have a space where they could come and just drink with other women without any sort of pressure or expectation. You have a drink when you walk in and you can mingle a bit, get to know people, and then we'll do a guided tasting. And then usually a brand ambassador or someone who is familiar with the product will walk us through. It's actually more about the social aspect of it, and then the whiskey is kind of the glue that brings everybody together.
This is my first Women Who Whiskey event. Loved it.
It's exciting. We took whiskey back.
When Julia invited us, we were excited to get an inside look at her world. Little did we know just how uncomfortable we would feel as guests at this all-women's event.
There's Eric, just feeling awkward. Doesn't have anyone to talk to.
Is it hot in here?
Every single woman here is here to chat with other women. So the fact that we're men here makes us very out of place. Which is a little bit tough for us, but you know what? What goes around comes around.
The success of Women Who Whiskey comes with its fair share of haters.
From men, the response that I get when I say that I run a women's whiskey group is like, oh, why just women? Like, why do you want to exclude men? And it's not about excluding men. And in fact, a lot of our events actually are co-ed. But the original spirit with which it was created was to create a space for women to kind of empower each other and be able to do something, not excluding men, but just in the absence of them. The power of groups like this is that they bring women together and they amplify a collective voice.
I'm Julia, founder of Women Who Whiskey.
Rally on!
If you like the music in this video, we found it using Soundstripe, a library of royalty-free music. They literally save us hours on every video because they make it so easy to find the perfect music for any mood, and you don't have to deal with any of that copyright stuff. So if you're a creator, go check them out.
Yeah. I do smell vanilla, and it also smells like my grandpa.